I must say I'm very proud to be Canadian, specifically when we realize and we hear what the Honorable Stephen Harper, our Prime Minister, has to say about Israel. We're moving on to a lady, a member of Knesset called Gila Gamliel. She is in the Knesset. She's in the Likud party. And this is what a typical Israeli has to say to their Christian friends.
Today, as we enter the new year, the Israeli population counts 7.6 million people, 5.6 million of which are Jews, with over 2 million Jewish children. As our prophet Jeremiah said, "Hineni meviotam me'eretz tzafon ve'kibatzti mi'arketei eretz, kahal gadol yeshuvu hena." I will bring them from the land of the north and gather them from the ends of the earth. A great community will return. Jerusalem is mentioned in the Bible 632 times. Jerusalem is not mentioned in the Islam holy book, the Quran, even once. In spite of continuous attempts, Jerusalem, the city of God, a united city and the capital of the state of Israel, will never again be divided. You, my dear friends, embody and understand the reason why Christians who believe in the Bible must support Israel. It is clearly stated in the scripture that those who believe in the Bible have a duty to support Israel. Israel is the fulfillment of God's promise to the children of Israel. The defense of biblical values in the modern world requires strong support for the land that is the source of these values. Benjamin Zev Herzl, the first father of political Zionism, once said, "Im tirtzu, en zo agadam." If you will, it is no legend. Israel is not legend. Israel is real. Israel has accomplished fantastic achievement in 62 years of independence, 62 years of construction and rebuilding of a nation, but also 62 years of struggle, bloodshed and war. Since 1948, we, the children of Israel, have defended the state of Israel with a Bible in one hand and a rifle in the other. Over 20,000 of our men and women paid their ultimate price in order to protect Israel's right to exist as a Jewish democracy. Israel today is a beautiful country, confident and secured by God. Amen. World leaders come to visit Israel. Tourists are flocking to Israel. Investors are investing in Israel, and Israeli technology used all over the world. Israel could not have attained all this without you. The support, your cooperation and friendship of you, my brothers and sisters, from all over the world. When I ask myself, why? Why Christians stand with Israel? The answer is simple. We share the same values. We have the same Bible, the same book. And we both love God more than all of the petroleum in the world.
We know the Word of God is the only answer to the darkness that seeks to cover the earth today.
Thank you for praying for the peace of Jerusalem. You will prosper who love her. Jerusalem is the city of the great King. We are a family here on the ground, flowing together for the goodness of Zion. We are privileged to be a part of Israel today. Thank you also for praying for us and for our sons, David, Chris, Josh, and Daniel, who are dedicated to sending the eternal light out into the darkness from Jerusalem.
3,000 years ago, the prophet Isaiah described today's world perfectly when he said, "For behold, the darkness shall cover the earth, and gross darkness the people. But arise, shine, for thy light has come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you, and the Gentiles shall come to thy light and to the brightness of thy rising."
We invite you to help us shine the light of our programs over the earth. With Israel at 60, we have exciting footage to offer you that won't be available anywhere else. Israel is the greatest single visible proof that the words of the Bible are made tangible and live among us today.
I couldn't agree more. The Bible says the entrance of your word gives light. It gives understanding. I love the practicality of it. The scriptures are priceless and more precious than gold, as the psalmist said, sweeter than honey and the honeycomb.
Thanks for your partnership with us. Your sponsorship of Israel Vision will make a huge difference in the hurting world today. Remember, the Almighty promised, "My word will not return void, but will accomplish the purpose that I intended." And that Messiah Yeshua said, "Heaven and earth will pass away, but my word will stand forever."